My name is Tom Hoke, and I am the President and CEO of Hennepin Theatre Trust, and on behalf of Hennepin Theatre Trust, I want to welcome you to our inaugural cabaret. Yeah. This is the first of what I hope will be many. This is an extension of our Spotlight Musical Theatre program. How many of you are familiar with that? Very good. Did any of you make it to the Spotlight Showcase in June? Yeah, is that great? Is that great? I wish I had been able to do that in high school. So, fabulous. Anyway, last year we served 47 schools, and this year we are going to be serving 53 schools. So it's incredible. And, you know, our goal with that program is to serve schools statewide. So there's several hundred that we can reach. So it's going to be fun to watch us grow and see how we do that. Tonight's cabaret is student-directed, student-ideated, student-created. It is all about students. And the t-shirt that I'm wearing was created by them as well. How do you like it? Yeah. Isn't that great? We're so excited. So the students that you'll see on stage and those who are off stage running the technical portion have created this entire thing. It's called Seven Deadly Sins. I don't know what that means. I haven't seen it. You be the judge. But I know it's inspired by the place where we are sitting this evening. To that end, I want to thank Hell's Kitchen and Kirsty Granberg for sponsoring and welcoming tonight's cabaret. Thank you. To that end, I want to encourage you to grab something to eat and drink, and I see many of you don't need any more encouragement, so that's a good thing. If you like what you see on tonight's stage and you are interested, we would encourage you to support the Spotlight program. There are a couple of things that you can do. On each of your tables is one of these, and how many of you are familiar with using a QR code? Yeah? Anybody not know what I'm talking about? Okay, so see this code here? If you have a phone, a smartphone, okay, well, if you know someone who has a smartphone, you can go ahead and if you go to the barcode or scan app there, all you have to do is aim your phone at this QR code and it will take you to the page where you can donate to Spotlight. So it's totally cool. So anyway, and if you're driving by our theaters frequently, you'll see a QR code up there. You can scan that and it will take you right to our website. You can see what shows are coming up. So it's the latest and the greatest. So if you aren't doing it, you are out of it and should be. The other thing is that I really want to I want to encourage you to become a supporter. And tonight, and only tonight, we have a special offer. For anyone who contributes $100, you'll get a free t-shirt. And it will look like this, and it will be, these are going to be collector items, I'm telling you, because this cabaret is the first of what are going to be many. It's going to be so popular in the next 5 years, you'll be like, I was there for the first one. You're going to want something that reminds you of it. So I encourage you to go ahead, donate tonight. We're going to try and raise $1,000 tonight. Okay, and that's all going to go to support the Spotlight Musical Theater Program. So if you have it in your heart and you have it in your checkbook to support us, any amount is welcome. If you give us $100 tonight, you'll get one of these. Or you can simply go back to the merch table where we have people and they'll be happy to sell you a t-shirt or some of our other merchandise which we have. So I thank you for that. I also want you to watch your emails for our August 10th event launching the New Century Theater and featuring Ryan McCartan. Are you familiar with Ryan?
Yeah.
If you're at the Spotlight Awards, you are, and he went on and he won the Nationals, so that's a big deal, okay? This guy is incredible. I mean, he really is incredible. Anyway, August 10th, we're going to have a little inaugural launching for the New Century Theater. Have you heard about that? Yeah, no, okay. Well, I'm going with the nose, and I'm going to tell you, okay? And that is our new performance space on the main floor of City Center. Okay, we are moving into space that has been vacant for 12 years. And we have moved our offices over there, so I encourage you to take a stroll through the main floor of City Center. You'll see our offices at the bottom of the escalator. Poke your head in, and if I'm there or any of our staff are there, and Hennepin Theatre Trust staff who are here, raise your hand so they know who you are. Thank you all. Anyway, if you see any of us, we will take you on a tour of that theater space so you can see it. It is going to be wonderful. It'll be 250 to 300 seats. We are lining up productions now, some of which our local theater organizations who are going to use the space, some of which are going to be us producing our own. So it's exciting. All the merchandise proceeds tonight, by the way, go to support the Spotlight program. And yeah, there's a merchandise table at the back of the room. Okay, let's see what else. Oh, you don't have to turn off your phone tonight. No, why? That's a good question. Because we're encouraging you to tweet throughout the show using the hashtag HTTCabaret or follow us on Twitter. We also welcome you to take pictures and like us on Facebook. There will be no intermission tonight, so feel free if you need to get up and use the restrooms, which are located back there, or to get something more to drink. And without further ado, Hennepin Theatre Trust now presents Seven Deadly Sins. Thanks.
Some of the greatest controversies this world has ever seen. For example, the controversy of the English monarchy, the slaying of Caesar, the American Civil War, and... Now, all of my friends have stories that stretch the length of eternity, but to save us some time, I will tell you seven. Seven stories about my seven dearest friends. I welcome all of you to have a listen to a story of the seven deadly sins. And you'll find that nowadays there are seven deadly ways for a soul to find its way into my group. Oh yes, these are stories that are nothing short of tragedy. But I swear to you, I only speak the truth. If you dismiss it as a lie, I can guarantee you'll die, and I'll keep your soul forever as my proof. Just try me.
Poor unfortunate souls who hate their lives.
This one pleading to be richer, he thinks, well, I'll rob a bank, and so he does it.
Then he does. These poor unfortunate souls without a clue.
Out of utter desperation, they all offer me their souls, and so I take them. Yes, I do. Now, a word of my advice, and I will not say it twice. Do not fall into these seven deadly holes.
That was beautiful. Woo!
I know. If you do, then you will see. You eternally will be just a poor unfortunate soul.
What do we have here?
On that true success stories only come from those who get started early. I remember way back in 2009, when I was just a little thing. I had a playground playmate named Sarah Crawford. Sarah had a Barbie doll she liked to flaunt at recess. Every day she would go around bragging how her doll was the best piece of plastic ever constructed. I'm not gonna lie, it was high quality. So what did I do? I stole the doll, ripped her apart, and began a world premiere industry specializing in the distribution of various Barbie parts and accessories. My efficiency turned me on to different agencies until I was picked up by Better Homes magazine to become the child figure in all the picturesque families. I've also been hired by various therapeutic practices to display the ideal person you can become after therapy. And look at me now! I'm perfect! My point is, nothing would have happened had I not worked for it, and now I get whatever I... What do you mean? I can't have a flying squirrel! I know about this! Why is it so difficult for you people to comprehend my requests?
Honey!
Shut up, Mom! Now I'm going to try this again. Someone take notes. I want a feast. I want a bean feast. Cream buns and donuts and fruit cake with no nuts. So good you could go nuts. I want a ball. I want a party. Pink macaroons and a million balloons and performing the moon dance. Give it to me. Now, I want the world.
Vomits to the left of the seat. There isn't any color to it. Why would there be? I haven't seen her eat in days. Why is it when I see global catastrophes, famine, genocide, I feel nothing? But the sight of her hunched over the toilet, crying, vomiting, why does that horrify me? In law school, I took a class called Case Analysis, and I read about a man who witnessed a kidnapping, and he didn't tell anybody. Didn't notify the authorities, nobody. Later that night, the victim was raped. Is a crime viable because of him? Is he guilty? Technically, the worst that could happen is he could be accused of depraved indifference, which is a fine of $100, maybe. Dehumanization aside, isn't he guilty? When I watch her hurt herself, and I do nothing, am I guilty? Why doesn't she see how beautiful she is? Anyone in their right mind could see that. There are times when I'm convinced that she's not perfect. Like, when she's purging and vomiting and crying. I've tried to do things, but nothing works. Nothing. I just have to sit there and do nothing. She left today. I'm too cold, apparently. Too cold. I guess that's the law student in me. I better go clean the bathroom. Usually by the time I'm done, she's back.
Standing in this room, well, I wonder what comes now. I know I have to help her, but hell if I know how. In all the times that I've been told the way her illness goes, the truth of it is no one really knows. And every day this act we act gets more and more absurd, and all my fears just sit inside me screaming to be heard. I know they won't throw not a single word. I was here at her side when she called, she cried. How could she leave me on my own? Will it work, this cure? There's no way to be sure. But I'm weary to the bone, and whenever she goes flying, I keep my feet right on the ground. There's no one around, and I've never had to face the world without her at my side. And I'm strolling right beside her as the black hole opens wide. Mine is just a slower suicide. I've been here for the show, every high, every low. But it's the worst we've ever known. Will it work? And how? But I can't give up now. 'Cause I've never been alone. I could never be alone.
Good afternoon, class. Today, I would like to discuss with you the raw, emotionless nature of the law. Emotions weigh you down and make you weak. A lawyer must be able to defend anyone and everyone, regardless of their beliefs. Today, I would like you to truly question your emotional stability. Examine Brown versus Board of Education of Topeka, the 1954 court case ruling that racially segregated schools were unconstitutional. I would like you to discuss the flaws and cons of this ruling. Yes, you, ma'am. Please come to the lecture podium.
Well, I believe that it is unjust to consider Brown versus the Board of Education of Topeka unconstitutional purely because of the fact that it served as a revolutionary basis that affected not only the African American population, but served as a turning point for the entire nation. Therefore, if we are to consider ourselves as a progressive and diverse population, we should make sure that we see it only as beneficial.
Yes, you, sir.
I hear and understand where you're coming from. However, based off your logic, we must then assume that all court cases that benefited a minority are out of efforts to benefit the greater good of the country. And as much as I would love to believe that we can all just hold hands and get along, the fact of the matter is that we're a nation built on opposition. Unanimous agreement is nothing more than fantasy, and to paint on an image of a perfect American government is fraud. However, that is the beauty of our court system. It is because of our oppositions that we form juries, which can collaborate from different angles and assist the ruling of our nation. I assure you that I'm coming from a completely racist-free platform, but the fact that Brown versus the Board of Education of Topeka had its flaws and controversies just like any other case presented through the American judicial system.
I see where you're going with this. Please continue.
I think a major critique for the population is to have less faith cemented in the parliamentary system and added elements of your own instincts. There isn't a case out there that doesn't leave someone without partial doubt. Take, for instance, the O.J. Simpson trial. Years of propaganda that any average American could have summed up in the simple sentence, "I wasted my tax dollars on a man we knew that was guilty from the start."
Sounds like a lawyer to me.
What's
new?
Got
new
drill.
That's great.
Thanks.
So, what's new with Tammy?
Who?
Your wife. Tammy?
Catherine, actually.
Catherine. Tammy. Not too far off.
She's fine. Well, we are in a bit of an argument right now. She wants to have children, you know, start a family, but here I am thinking I'm 2 years out of college, too young. I want to start making money before I begin providing for a family.
That's so wrong of her. I would completely understand. You should divorce her. Kidding, of course.
Yeah, kidding. On the subject of families, congrats to you guys.
Why do you say that?
You're pregnant. What do you do? Not pregnant.
Not even a little.
You look fine. You look great. Not, you don't look pregnant. It's just that, you know.
I have to pee.
You have fun now. You are wind and water and sky. Darling, tell me, darling, how I can earn your love. I would swim oceans, I would move mountains, I would do anything for you. What would you want me to do? I am unworthy of your love. Darling, darling, let me prove worthy of your love. Tell me how I can earn your love. Set me free. How can I turn your love?
to leave.
Hey, listen, I'm really sorry about that comment. I meant no harm.
Oh, I had completely forgotten. Don't worry about it. May I borrow your stapler?
Oh, absolutely.
Dump his baggage and get with his office chick. That's why I pursue college chicks. They're hot and smart, like me. My ex was way too high school and totally immature. It was time for an upgrade. I'm moving on, and you know what? That's fine. Truth is, regardless of age, women really just want one thing.
Girls are dreaming just one dream, nearly all their lives. Hoping, scheming, just one theme. Will they be a wife? Will they be some he-man's property? Hoping that he wins me. Let me tell you how this dream can help a girl like you. Women can have their uses too, mainly to extend the family tree. Hoping to extend with me.
You want my love, take it all. Come on now. watch it fall. Oh, we know it's your show, so take it all. I met him on a Wednesday afternoon in November. I had just moved and it was my first day of class. He offered to take me a tour on school and, well, we skipped class and ran around the building for hours. Then we were in the bathroom making out before school came out, and from then on I had clung to him. I clung to him like a stupid lost puppy. And for 3 years of my life, after 3 years, he told me that he wanted something more meaningful, something bigger and better. Apparently devoting the last 3 years of my life wasn't good enough. I tell you, it's all the same. Women can't get any R-E-S-P-E-C-T anymore. It's all about the male dominance factor. And I'll tell you what, if you want something more meaningful, you can mark my words. I hate men. I can't abide them even now and then. They never marry one of them, I'd rest a maiden rather. For husbands are a boring lot and only give you bother. Of course, I'm awfully glad that mother had to marry father. Still, I hate men. Of all the types I've ever seen within our democracy, I hate the mousy athlete with his manner bold and brassy. He may have hair upon his chest, but sister, so has Lassie. I hate men.
I might be insane. I know crazy people don't know they're crazy, but I think I might be. I love him. I love him so much that I hate him, and I hate him because, well, because I loved him more than I ever loved myself. I've lost all control. I am completely his to batter and destroy, and helpless. The worst thing about it is that he's never done anything wrong or harmful to me. You know, he makes me feel like I'm the villain. But I'm not. I will not be the victim. No. Every night I watch him. And there are a few moments where I'm not convinced that he's perfect. It's, when he has that coldness about him. This face drained of emotion. A robot. Lying there beside me, reading and working. I don't even exist, and I have no control over that. And then I purge because it assures me that I will always feel something. I'll always feel ugly, ashamed. And I'll always have some sense of control, and I will never be a robot. God, and then I get so furious with him because it doesn't have to be this way. He is draining himself of joy, and he is dragging me down with him. I just keep giving myself, and he has all of me. And I have lost everything to him. You see? I'm crazy. So I look at him, and I say,
you want the movements to see what the hips can do. Come watch the slinky girl, see how the pasties twirl. To make your bells all ring, look at everything you ever wanted. So go ahead, take it all.
Watch your eyes.
maybe this time from the musical Cabaret. Maybe this time I'll be lucky. Maybe this time I'll stay. Maybe this time, for the first time, I won't hurry away. I will soon be cast. I'll have a part and love. Not a loser.
Hey, thank you, that's all I need.
Hey there, I'm singing Lush Life.
Those come what may places where one relaxes on the axis of the wheel of life to get the feel of life through jazz and cocktails. Then you came along with your siren song to tempt me to madness. I thought for a while that your apartment smile was tinged with the sadness of a good love for me. Ah, yes, I was wrong. Again, I was wrong. Life is lonely.
Opportunity, and I hope to work with you at some point in the future. first time. I won't hurry away.
Q&A, if any of you are interested, for sticking after and asking any questions about the Trust, about the Cabaret series. So yeah, you're all welcome, and thank you again so much.